my wonderful viewers, welcome to my platform. This is Linda's TV show. If you like what you see after watching this video, please subscribe, put on your notification bell to all notifications. In that way, you'll be able to know when I upload a new video. This is very, very important. In this platform, we react to all forms of videos, international and local. And every Saturday by 2 p.m., we have our interaction section where you are free to air your mind, to contribute to the happenings in our societies. Share my videos with your friends, families, and colleagues. And myself, I'll be sitting here to watch this video together with you. Then later, we'll come to the comment section to talk about it. We'll write our comment in a constructive manner. As we watch this video, remember to share.
Mistake anybody can do is to allow themselves to become divided. To allow this very period is critical. Everybody, if you are out protesting, continue to do your protest peacefully. Only when you are fired out, you fire back, and you must also defend yourselves. We know that they are trying to organize themselves. I told you before, if you listen to us, you can never go wrong. They are going to try everything. Remember when the protest started, they brought their thugs. Have you forgotten? And we said, stay, remain very strong and resolute. Defeat them. Their thugs were defeated and they ran away. They started through the intimidation. It did not work. They tried to bribe the organizers or those they think are the leaders on the ground. It did not work. Now they brought the army to shoot. And that still did not work. They are now playing the final card. And that is to tell you that freedom is very close. The final card they are playing is this. They want to introduce ethnicity. They want to say that what is happening is ethnically motivated. No, it is not. That is what Britain is going to do. That was what they did. They divided Awolowo and Azikiwe. The same thing they are doing now. They want to divide IPOB and Yoruba One Voice. They understand their game plan. That is what they are doing. That is the mission of APC. They have poured money into this project. But they have failed. I want you to understand, if you want to know the reason why Awolowo never worked with Nnamdi Azikiwe, what is happening now will tell you. People are fighting for a better tomorrow, a better future for themselves, for the indigenous populations that Britain put together in a place called Nigeria, in a zoo. People are fighting to liberate themselves. And somebody, instead of being concerned about the welfare of people that died at Lekki Toll Gate, how the army massacred them, you see APC, they want to shift the narrative to, oh, it is evil. Nnamdi Kanu gave the order and Tinubu's hotel was burnt. Nnamdi Kanu gave the order and Toll Gate was destroyed. All errant nonsense. When we were alive on the air and the whole world knew what was happening, do you see how they want to divide you? Do you see how they want to weaken you? Because they know that youths of Nigeria, if you stand as one, if you stand as one, nobody can defeat you. You are fighting for your future. They may come to you to give you 500 naira. They may give you 1,000 naira. They may want to buy over your conscience. When the 1,000 naira is not working, they may go somewhere and they say, oh, it is evil. They want to take over our land. Somebody called from Igbocha or maybe from somewhere else, I do not know. The person said Oyinbo. And I thought they were talking about Oyinbo in Igbocha, Obibo. That's what I said. Do you know what they said? They twisted it. They said, I am now renaming parts of Lagos as Obibo. That if this thing continues, that means that Biafra is going to take over Lagos. Do you see what they are doing? Do you see how they want to sow seeds of discord? Do you see how they want to destroy everybody? Do you see what the game they are playing? And I'm telling you the truth. It is their final card. They have nothing else to do after this. It is called divide and rule. Divide and rule. If you allow them to divide you in this revolution, if you allow them to say Biafra, Oduduwa, Yoruba, and this, Fulani, Hausa, you are gone, believe you me. That was why I gave the order. Do not attack any mosques. Please don't. And all of you in the north, don't allow any churches to be attacked. They want to divide you. That is how Nigeria works. Once they divide you, you are finished. You are finished. This is a glorious opportunity. It's a glorious opportunity. They are playing their usual games. That is the way they are. They will play these games to deceive you. They will play it so you will leave the revolution and start saying, oh, I'm looking for Igbo property, Igbo business to destroy in Lagos, so that APC can amplify it. Because there is no president in Asorok. There is no vice president in Asorok. I warned you. I told you. There is no Buratai. I do not know. They don't want to come out in the open to say who amongst themselves is issuing directives. So I can curse that person. You draw on, I will curse you and you will die. The same way we cursed all of them and they died. We are telling our young people today that the future of Africa are in your hands. How you handle this opportunity will define what history will say about you. That is why this program this morning is very, very important. Very, very important. Somebody called and said, Oyibo. And I corrected him and I said, it's Oyibo in Igwacha. Do you know that some people working for Tinubu, they concocted with APC, with House of Work, with Britain, yesterday, they were saying, I want to rename Lagos. They think our young people are stupid. They are very, very smart. If they give you 500 naira or 1,000 naira to go and attack your businesses, you tell them no. Federal government properties in Lagos, they are not individual businesses. I have said it. Do not touch anybody's private business. No, no, no. People came on air and went to vent their anger because they saw their fellow compatriots, their fellow citizens lying dead, shot by an army that was meant to be protecting them. And as I said to them, your lies can never last long. Your deception can never last long. Our young people are smart and they are very, very intelligent. They are no longer stupid. They are no longer animals in the zoo. They are the future that we have. And we salute them. If you allow yourself as a protester, as a revolutionary, if you allow yourselves to be deceived into fighting a tribal war, into fighting an ethnic war, Britain would have won. Your lives would be miserable. There will be no light from NEPA. There will be no good schools, no hospitals, no sewage system, no running water. Your lives will be miserable. Now is the time to take your future into your hands. By the way you behave, by the way you behave today, tomorrow, and day after, will determine if you want to be free or not, or if you want to be controlled by criminals or not. That is how things are. There are some people whose job it is to collect money from corrupt politicians to corrupt your mind. Say no to it now. All of you are protesting, saying to police, Say no to bribery. Don't take bribe at checkpoints. I am now asking you this morning to say no to ethnic division. Say no to those of them that want to divide you. Say no to those of them who have come to give you money to attack each other when you should be attacking them. Anybody who gives you money to go and attack somebody else, first of all, attack that very person. You must not give up. The message this morning to all those who are trooping out to go and protest is never give up. They are going to play one final card, please. I refuse. I did not tell you this before. There is one last card they will play. Now the game of ethnic division, divide and rule, we are going to defeat it today. Our media teams will be on overdrive. Some will be reporting about the protest, and some also will be reporting on the issue of this very matter. Our people cannot be divided. And I have said it before, I don't want any banks to be touched. I don't want anybody, Maybe the, some of the banks we are told that people got angry and they did something about it was because the police was there firing at people, so they got upset. Nobody went out to attack any banks. Nobody attacked any banks at all. People were upset because the Zoo Army hit there to be firing at protesters. This day today, you must be united. Don't say something that you do not mean. When you say united we stand and divided we fall, that mantra is absolutely correct. If you allow yourselves to be divided, as our young youths, as our future and our hope, believe you me, your dream will die today. Don't allow them to deceive you. Don't allow them to deceive you. If you are at any protest ground, if you are anywhere where people are gathered, tell the people who are planning to carry out any attacks that they want to divide us. If they divide us, we are finished. And once you keep saying it to that very person, before you say it up to 7 times, they will repent. They are young people and they too are suffering. They are young people and they are suffering as well. Everybody wants a better tomorrow. Everybody wants a better tomorrow. But the businesses that belongs to corrupt individuals, to looters and to criminals, the list is now about to be published. We want to let them understand something, that power belongs to this generation. Power belongs to this generation 2020. Nobody is going to take their future away from them. Nobody can. No politician is going to deceive them. During elections, they give you Indomie. During elections, they give you broom. During elections, they give you a cup of rice and a cup of beans. And after elections, they forget you for 4 years. Now they want to do the same thing. We are not fighting an election. We are fighting a monster you cannot see. And that monster is going to succeed if we do 2 things. This morning, the whole world is listening to this broadcast. The monster is going to succeed if you people, you our brave heroes on the ground, if you make 2 cardinal mistakes. Azikiwe and Awolowo made the same mistakes. If you make it now, their life is over. The same way they are using some people now to try to divide the East and the West was how they used Akintola to try to divide Azikiwe and Awolowo, and they succeeded, and that is the reason why the Janjaweed are in charge. You must use your brain. Don't allow them to use you in Lagos, in Enugu, in Igbocha, in Aba. Don't allow these criminals to divide you. They cannot divide you. It doesn't matter who they are. You are one. You came out as one. You are going to fight as one, and you're going to win as one. Remain determined and remain resolute. Remain determined and you remain resolute. The entire APC machinery is out. When I told you that black people are useless, now you can understand it. They say you insult black people. All the time you insult black people. Do you see what I'm saying? You are fighting for your future. A young boy, a graduate who was unemployed, because APC picked you up, because a politician picked you up and gave you some cash, you want to impoverish other young people around you by supporting evil. I told you before that they always support evil. They always support evil. But today, that evil is consuming them. That evil is consuming them. I need assurance from our young people on the ground that they will never ever allow any ethnic or tribal coloration into this revolution. Once you do it, you will fail. But they are going to sponsor their thugs to do it for them. That is what they do. That goes to show how much they hate you. A government that hires thugs to go and kill people, those who claim they are professors, they are learned, they are lecturers, they are intellectuals, are peddling a primitive narrative, very primitive, tribe. It was in Lagos doing this, these are that. But can you see how primitive they are? Do you see how primitive they are? But they claim they are professors, so They're intellectuals. These are intellectuals gossiping like little children. Gossiping like little children. Don't allow yourselves to be divided. They cannot divide us, and they will not divide us. If you listen to what we are saying this morning, this revolution will be a success. And in 3 weeks' time, or less than 3 weeks' time, you will celebrate a future that is filled with hope and aspiration. If you mess it up today, then you are finished. There is something that I want the protesters to ask for everywhere today. Ask to see the president of Nigeria. That's all you need to do. Ask to see the president of Nigeria. That is the only thing that you need to do today. Keep asking to see him. You want to see him. He doesn't exist, I assure you. They have been preparing and coaching him. They have been doing all they can, bringing many people and throwing a mask on their face to see if it is going to fit. It has not worked so far. Britain is sweating because their business company is collapsing. They are sweating. As I am talking to you this very morning, as I am speaking to you this very morning, they are in a panic mode. If we remain together strong and solid, we are going to win. If we remain together strong and solid, victory is ours. These are the things you ought to know. And this very morning, we must prove to the world that the young people of Nigeria, the youth of Nigeria, they are in this together. They are one together with their brethren all over the world to bring to an end an era, or should I say, decades of evil and impurity. And that is happening before our eyes. We are live and we are direct. And very, very shortly, we are going to take your calls. Very, very shortly, I will take your calls, please. And you must listen very carefully. That is why you must listen live to what we are doing. I was having a sip of water. Because if you do not listen live to what we are doing, you will not be able to follow instructions. If you do not follow instructions, Britain will win. You will continue to be an animal in a zoo, in a cage. Now is the time to free yourself. But first of all, you must free yourself mentally. As a young person, even if you're a tout or you're an abu, you also want a better life for yourself and your children. Don't allow these devilish politicians to deceive you. They are enjoying themselves with their private jets. They are enjoying themselves everywhere. If you allow them to deceive you, to make this battle, that of Yoruba and Igbo in Lagos, or maybe Hausa and Fulani somewhere else, they would have destroyed you. They would have destroyed you. Now, the government of Ekiti State have sponsored thugs in Ekiti State. That's what they're doing. The thugs are armed with pump action guns and now on the streets of Ado Ekiti, shooting indiscriminately to prevent the end SARS protest. Do you see why you must go after corrupt politicians? Everywhere right across the country, you must catch them. That is how revolutions work. They are now trying to mobilize their forces of darkness. Anywhere you see them, you go after them. It is APC governorship aspirant in 2018 that is sponsoring what is happening in Ekiti. And we are asking our people over there, when I say our people, I mean the people who are out on the streets, the young people who are protesting. When I talk about our people, I mean people who are protesting. Because if I am out on the streets, I'll be doing the same thing with them. When you use the word our people, it doesn't mean IPOB, it means all the young people who are protesting. You must understand this. Those are the narratives that the enemies are spewing. Those are the narratives they are peddling to divide you. The young people carrying pump action in Ekiti. You also have a future to defend. But they have given you money and you have come out with pump action. to try to destroy your own hope and your own future. Your hope and your future. And that is not good. That is not good. They are now unleashing their thoughts. They are now unleashing their thoughts. Very, very sad indeed. And we are going to fight them. We are going to fight them. We are going to fight them. And they cannot succeed because power does indeed belong to the people. We are live and we are direct. And Chukwu Okike Abiam is our guide. Chukwu Okike Abiam is our guide. We are live and we are direct. And Elohim is bearing us witness. Don't allow them to deceive you. Don't allow them to deceive you. Do not, never, ever allow them to deceive you. They will not succeed, not now, not tomorrow, and not ever. Never, ever, ever. They will never, ever succeed. They will succeed. The revolution is in full gear. I have not slept properly for very many days. It's unbelievable. Please do excuse me. We are live and we are direct this very morning. And Elohim is bearing us witness. They cannot divide our young people. If you know what you can do to counter the evil narrative, it must and should be done now. They cannot divide you. The young people must stand as one. The youths must stand as one. The youths must stand as one. Very, very critical, please. Very, very critical. The situation in the Zulu Nigeria, which has boiled over in recent days, is an accumulation of the wanton, systematic malaise and evil that the Fulani Janjaweed cabal has brought into your lives, have baited British mediocrity. They have brought into your lives. You must resist them, and resist them you shall. This very day, they are trying to divide us. They are trying to divide us, and they will never succeed. They will never, ever succeed. Please do bear with me. And very shortly, our lines are going to open. They are going to open, and we shall take your calls. We shall take your calls. Please do bear with me, please. We are fixing a few things here. We are fixing a few things here, please. We must defeat our enemies. We must defeat our enemies. As I'm talking to you, I'm also issuing directives and sending out messages. Very, very important, please. Very, very important you understand this. They are not going to defeat us. They cannot defeat us now. I have issued, even whilst I've been talking to you on air, I've been able to issue instructions to our media people to make sure that the statement I crafted before we came on air is everywhere. That it is everywhere. Our youths cannot be deceived. Our young people cannot be deceived. And this morning, I am going to give you a number to call. I am going to give you a number to call. We are live and we are direct. And the enemies are doing all they can to divide us, but we cannot afford to let them do that. I am going to give you a number to call this morning. The number is +49 162 730 6732. That is the only number to call today, please. +49 162 730-6732. The reason why we keep changing our numbers is so we can keep track of all the messages that you are sending. All the messages you are sending, please, very, very important. Very, very critical that we do this very day, please. That is the number to call. That is the number to call this very morning. Especially for those who are at protest grounds, that is the number to call. If you are out on the streets as a revolutionary, that is the number to call, please. That is the number to call. We are live and we are direct this very morning, and we are doing all we can to make sure that our program goes out uninterrupted this very day. We want to find out what is happening on the ground. Some of you who are on Facebook are now sending your messages. The caller on the line, can you hear me? I actually called you back. What is happening where you are? Tell me where you are and what is happening. Can you hear me? No, they cannot hear me. The caller on the line, can you hear me? Can you hear? No, these people are even those who are calling from abroad. I will take their calls today. The caller on the line, can you hear me? Raise your voice for me. Your voice is very low. Very, very low. Raise your voice for me.
Good morning, my supreme leader. I can hear you.
Thank you very much. Please, where are you calling from?
I'm calling you from Cosenza, Italy.
And please go ahead. What do you have to say?
Okay, my leader, I have a very little contribution I want to ask you. I don't know if it's important or not, but because I am seeing and I believe and I know what is happening and the determination of our people back home, which we support them very well, because on Monday we had a protest in Rome here, even though I know I'm a Biafran, but the protest was about the Nigerian, but we had a very successful protest. And on Sunday, we are protesting once again in Milan. So, but there is one thing I am asking, I don't know if it is good, you think about it. I am suggesting we that are living in Europe here, because if any war breaks out, definitely we are coming home to defend our lands. If there are any means that we can organize ourselves together to have some partial trainings to be ready more. This is what I wanted to contribute. I don't know if it is very important or if it is necessary, but I suggest this, maybe you look up to it. This is what I want to say. Thank you.
Thank you very much. It will be considered. And now, somebody gave me an advice which I have taken. When I say my people or our people, the criminal politicians will twist it and say I am addressing IPOB family members on the ground. I will from now onwards be using the word Nigerian youths. I will no longer say our people. I will no longer use the word our people. I will simply say Nigerian youths. As simple as that. So they have no need or reason to lie, to distort, and to deceive the world. The Nigerian youths who are out protesting today, we commend them. We commend them immensely. We commend them immensely. Stop talking rubbish. Umar has called Andra. Stop talking nonsense. Who told you that Umar has called Andra? Umar has been working for days of telling me he's called Andra. Stop writing rubbish saying he's called Andra. Everywhere things are happening, people are coming out and protesting. And that is what we want to encourage. Don't allow the politicians to deceive you. Don't allow them to deceive you. You must mount barricades everywhere.
Thank you so much for watching this video together with me. Like I said before, if it is your first time of coming across my YouTube channel and you like what I do, please subscribe, put on your notification bell. Share this video, leave your comment in the comment section. You are free to criticize, but let us do it always constructively, Remain blessed. I appreciate your massive support and I love and cherish each and every one of you. Until I meet you again in my next video, for now, I will say bye-bye.